Hello, my name is Henry Kuriamaina and I'm from Nairobi, Kenya. I'm here to speak about COVID-19 and how I was diagnosed to be COVID-19 positive and how I was able to overcome that. So the first instance when we heard about COVID-19, it was not something of which was very close to me. But in fact, people, I would also ask the same question that people are asking: who have you heard that they have COVID? We thought this to be more of like a government scheme whereby they would just give numbers. But one day I traveled, upon coming back to Nairobi, I tested. And the reason why I was not testing because I was sick. I didn't have any symptoms. I was very healthy. The reason why I went to test was because my boss actually asked me to test. I wanted to go back to work. My boss had recalled me back to work. There was one rule that if you go to work, you had to do a 14-day quarantine before you mix up with the other people. So instead of me doing the 14 days quarantine, my boss actually asked me, instead of doing the 14 days, why don't you just test? This was courtesy, or this was because there was a youth event that was coming by. It was very close. So he wanted me to partake within the youth program. When I heard about this, I called a friend, and when I went to test, I was expecting to get the results within 24 hours. But it was not until the fifth day that I received a call acknowledging that my tests came out positive. So during that time, I was shocked. I was totally shocked. I started calculating, or I started thinking about my family. By that time, I had two children and my wife was pregnant. So I was thinking, how is it going to be? This was because COVID-19 was highly associated with death. At least for me right now, I know that someone can become a COVID-19 survivor. But back then, if you had COVID or you were tested with corona, then actually people took you as a corpse. Like, even if you're not dead, but people actually translated this to be dead. When the doctor called me, the person who called me, and then they advised me to do a quarantine from my own house, I did that for day one. On day two, a different doctor called me and actually directed me that I had to be picked up to go for a government-sponsored quarantine. At some point, they also pushed me that my family would also be taken, also go for testing and all these kind of things. But, you know, the way of which people were evacuated from their homes was not a very good picture. And it was stigmatizing, and there was a lot of discrimination also from the members of the estate and the neighborhood. So we made plans to be picked away from the estate. So I was picked away from my estate. I had one ambulance and a police escort. So when I went to the quarantine, you know, it became so hard for me that I could not associate with other people. The thought of death, the thought of me not surviving was so hard that I could not interact with other people, thinking that now they were the ones who are more of a risk to me. But the youth program that I spoke about, on day two of my quarantine, it began. And I heard about the Leaning Tower of Pisa. This is a building that was built. Upon it being built, some point it slanted at 4 degrees. So it's like it's falling. So the engineers thought about demolishing it, but some people said, no, let's not demolish it. So until today it stands. And the lecture which I had was that this building has now become a tourist attraction. So when I thought about my life, I thought about, you know, how I can't protect myself, how I was weak, how even if I had COVID, there was nothing I could do. So I highly thought about it, and the Leaning Tower became a very big encouragement, because irrespective that it's falling, it has become a tourist attraction. So I thought about it in this way: even if I have COVID, it's okay, no problem, I can overcome. So through this, I was able to overcome this. I started interacting with the people around me. Much in fact, I became more of an encouragement to other people that we were with within the quarantine period. And I saw how, you know, this one lecture was able to help me. Beforehand, as you all know, a doctor cannot treat themselves. So I was the one who was going around motivating people and you know, kind of giving them a positive mindset. But it was not until I found myself in such kind of a situation that I realized the power of, you know, gaining something different from other people. When I listened about the Leaning Tower of Pisa, I was able to change. My wife is healthy, my kids are healthy, I came out from quarantine, and I'm very happy to actually know that, you know, there is a weakness of which can turn out to be a helping aspect in one's life. So thank you very much, and I hope one day to also visit the Leaning Tower of Pisa. Thank you.